Students, let's today talk about vascular system. It's a kind of a complex tissue in plants. Complex ka matlab kya hoga? Complex means when a tissue is made up of more than one type of cells. Now, like, can you give me a pen? I'll show you what is a xylem. What are xylem and phloem? Now, suppose this pen, this ball pen, has a riffle inside. Dikh rahi hai? Can you see this? Okay. Now, this riffle is supposed to be the xylem. जैसे इसमें इंक आप देख रहे हो निब तक आती है, ऐसे ही जाइलम जो है वो रूट से वाटर को लेकर जाता है अप टू द एरियल पार्ट ऑफ द प्लांट, टू द ग्रोइंग टिश्यूज, एवरी पार्ट ऑफ द प्लांट. ठीक है. ओके. तो जाइलम बेसिकली इज़ अ कॉम्प्लेक्स टिश्यू विच इज़ मेड अप ऑफ मेनी सेल्स. सो दिस इज़ विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द वास्कुलर सिस्टम. वास्कुलर बंडल, बंडल मीन्स कि द टिश्यू इज़ टुगेदर इन अ बंडल. वास्कुलर का मतलब होगा कि इट इज़ द नरिशिंग टिश्यू और इट इज़ द कंडक्टिंग टिश्यू दैट गिव्स फूड एंड वाटर टू द दैट गिव्स फूड एंड वाटर टू द वेरियस पार्ट्स ऑफ द प्लांट. सो जाइलम बेसिकली विल बी सप्लाइंग वाटर टू द प्लांट पार्ट्स. नाउ जाइलम इज फर्दर मेड अप ऑफ various types of cells like tracheids, vessels, xylem parenchyma and xylem fibers. So let's talk about tracheids now. So one of the type of cells in the vascular system xylem is tracheids. Tracheids are spindle shaped structures . Spindle means they have tapering pointed ends. They have pits. In fact, they'll be conducting water through the pits only. The dead tissue is because they have lignin deposition in the cell walls that makes it dead. So let us see how a tracheid looks like. So they are like a spindle shaped structure. Spindle shape means they have a tapering end. Tapering end means they are like a जैसे आपने बेलन देखा होगा या एक फिरकी, that they are tapered or pointed at the ends and they are thicker at the middle portion. They got pits in the side wall. And through these pits, water will be moving up. This is as good as the water moves in a cotton wick in a maybe like a Diwali ke diye. So that is how water will be moving up in through the tracheids. So now let's talk about vessels. Now vessels are a bit broader, they are tube like structures, they have pits in the side wall, there are pits all over. And they have pores in the end plates also, they have pits here also. तो चारों तरफ इसमें होल्स होते हैं, दे आर ट्यूब लाइक एंड इन अ प्लांट इन अ जाइलम दे आर प्लेस्ड वन ओवर द अदर, एक के ऊपर एक, लाइक दिस. सो देयर एंड प्लेट्स आर पोरस, देयर साइड वॉल्स आर पोरस, वाटर कैन मूव थ्रू दी साइड वॉल्स एंड विद इन द ट्यूब ऑल्सो. these are the pores here. Here. So through these pores, water will be moving, like as if it is moving within the, that was moving in the tracheids also, similarly in the same way, from the side walls or through the end plates upwards. If you ever seen a wood cut plant, cut tree, तो आपने क्या देखा होगा, उसके अंदर जो होल्स होते हैं वो होल्स दे आर द बेसिकली द वेसल पोर्स, तो वही होते हैं वेसल पोर्स. नाउ इफ यू एवर हैव एवर हैड अ स्ट्रॉ इन योर कोल्ड ड्रिंक, सो नाउ लेट मी टेल यू कि हाउ दिस वाटर मूव्स अप. तो जैसे स्ट्रॉ को आपने पानी में डाला, या आपके ग्लास में अगर सपोज कुछ लिक्विड है और उसमें आपने स्ट्रॉ डाला हुआ है, यू नो कि स्ट्रॉ जो है that is a bit narrower than the glass diameter. Okay, now so what happens, the water will be raising a little bit more than that of the glass level. So suppose glass mein pani sirf yahan tak hai, so the water in the this straw will be a little bit at a higher this level. Have you ever seen this? Okay, now suppose agar mera straw aur bhi patla hota, it is still narrower, so what will happen, water will rise further up. Exactly in the same way vessels may be hota hai. So vessels are like thin straw within the plant's xylem, and water will be moving up, that will be maintaining a column within the xylem vessel. Now thinner the vessel, more will be the water level in the vessel. तो जितनी पतली आपकी स्ट्रॉ होगी कोल्ड ड्रिंक के अंदर, उतना ज़्यादा कोल्ड ड्रिंक का लेवल जो है उस स्ट्रॉ में ऊपर जाएगा. तो एग्जैक्टली ऐसे ही बहुत सारी ऐसी फाइन ट्यूब वेसल्स होंगी और ये पानी को ऊपर की तरफ लेकर जाएंगे. सो वेसल क्या होगा, वेसल इज़ अ फाइन ट्यूब लाइक स्ट्रक्चर विद लिग्निन इन द वॉल दैट मेक्स इट डेड अगेन. सो इट्स अ डेड टिश्यू. It has pits all over the side wall and the end plates, so that water can move through this. Now the lignin deposition is again in a various pattern. So it's only the pores that will be left, the pits, except for everywhere else in the wall there will be lignin deposition. So lignin makes it dead. And not only that, it helps in the providing the mechanical support, so that makes the wall tough and strengthens it. Let's talk about xylem parenchyma. Now they are the live cells and they perform storage and secretion function. कोई भी live cell हमेशा यही दो function करता है. Now they are thin walled. Live cell is always thin walled, and this is the only live cells within the whole of xylem tissue. Okay, next is xylem fibers. Now fibers means they are made up of sclerenchyma and they are always dead. So kabhi bhi dead tissue hoga to uska basic function kya hoga, they will be for mechanical support and strengthening the tissue wherever it is present. So let's now talk about phloem. Phloem is also a complex tissue, and phloem helps in transportation of sugars, food. Now food will be transported from the source to the sink. Source kya hoga? Source will be the leaves, where it will be synthesized glucose, and from there it will be transported to the roots, because the roots are non-green. In fact, this can also be transported to the new meristematic tissue, where it will be where there will be new tissues forming. Now this transport can be from the storage organ. A storage organ could be the chloroplast, or it could be the stem or the other cells, from where this could be transported to the new leaves. Suppose जैसे spring season में होता है तो spring season में क्या होगा, the plant will be losing all the leaves, but during the spring season there will be new leaves and the new this birds that will come up. So there the new, for forming the new leaves again the food will be required. Now suppose this is the stem of the plant, so this is the phloem and the leaves. Leaves are supposed to be the source means the food will be synthesized within the leaves, and from here it can move either up to the roots or up to the fruits where it has to be stored and the new buds. So it is bidirectional. Phloem में जब food move करेगा तो ये bidirectional होगा. It can go from the source to sink. Source is the leaves, sink could be the roots, and sink could be the storage organ or the new meristematic part of the plant. So ये fruit में भी देखो ऐसे जा सकता है, या जो नई leaves बन रही है वहाँ भी जा सकता है. So this is explained by the theory called source to sink theory. ये एक मंच हाइपोथेसिस कहलाता है, मंच हाइपोथेसिस, वेयर द फूड इज मूविंग फ्रॉम सोर्स टू सिंक. लेकिन जाइलम में ऐसे नहीं था. जाइलम का ट्रांसपोर्ट जो था दैट वाज यूनिडायरेक्शनल, दैट विल ऑलवेज बी फ्रॉम रूट्स टू द एपिकल पार्ट, एरियल पार्ट. बट फ्लोएम्स ट्रांसपोर्ट इज बाय डायरेक्शनल. दिस यू नीड टू रिमेंबर. So now let's talk about the sieve tubes. तो phloem के जो various components हैं उसमें the one of the most important cell is sieve tubes. Sieve tubes are all pitted, the walls are all pitted, even the end plates are pitted. Sieve means I'm talking about chalni. So there are pits all over, side wall में भी pits हैं और end plates में भी. Then they are associated with the companion cells and the phloem parenchyma. So these are the parenchyma cells, they are live. Now important thing about phloem is that all the cells here are live except for the phloem fibers. Now important thing is ki yahan pe sieve tubes live to hain but they lack nucleus. And I can compare the sieve tubes with human RBCs, yeah, mammalian RBCs. Like mammalian RBCs are highly specialized and they'll be lacking nucleus, but still they are called live. So similarly, sieve tubes may be nucleus to nahi hoga, but wo live cells hote hain. So they are highly specialized. Now the sieve tubes have peripheral cytoplasm this way. They got a central big vacuole. Now these are the companion cells. Again they are live and they are having nucleus. In fact the nucleus of companion cell will be helping the sieve tubes in their functioning. You know kya function hota hai sieve tubes ka? They help in transport of sugars. So that will be helped by the nucleus of companion cell. That is why they are called companion. So these are the, this is the cytoplasm at the periphery. Central is a big vacuole, sieve at the ends, So now let's talk about sieve tubes. They are live cells, highly specialized. They lack nucleus and they work along with the companion cells. They have pits in the sidewall as well as in the sieve plates. Their end plates are having pores and they transport food in the form of dissolved sucrose. So the food is transported along with water, so we say it is in the dissolved form, en masse, together with water. So the sieve tubes have cytoplasm at the periphery and a big vacuole in the center part. They don't have any nucleus. So now let's talk about the next thing, that is the companion cells. Now the companion cells, as the name indicates, are the companion to the sieve tubes. In fact, they are always associated with the sieve tubes. In fact, the functioning of sieve tube is under the control of the nucleus of companion cells. So next is the phloem parenchyma. Now phloem parenchyma are the live cells, and as the other cells are, and they'll be helping in storage and secretions. कोई भी लाइव सेल हमेशा स्टोरेज एंड सिक्रीशन करता है. सो लाइव सेल्स हेल्प इन स्टोरेज एंड सिक्रीशंस. देन देर आर फ्लोएम फाइबर्स. नाउ व्हेन आई से फाइबर्स, सो फाइबर्स विल ऑलवेज बी द डेड टिश्यू मेड अप ऑफ स्क्लेरेन्काइमा. So, dead provide mechanical support, made up of sclerenchymatous tissue. Now, इनकी एक और खास बात ये है कि इनको हम यूज़ करते हैं रोप बनाने के लिए. And there they are called the bast fibers, BAST. So they are the bast fibers used to make ropes. जो रस्सी बनती है, that is made by these. That is nothing but the phloem fibers only. जिसको bast fibers भी बोलते हैं, it's the same thing. Now they are dead tissue because they have lignin deposition in the cell wall. So whenever I say the tissue is dead, so it is basically the cell wall that is deposited with the lignin kind of thing. Now there are certain plants like there is flax, jute and linum. In teen plants se ki madad se hum log banate hain rassi. Aur in paudon ko, when they are of a few meters height, in height, they are cut from the just above the ground. They are made into bundles and inko kisi ek pani ke kisi मे बी एक वेल के अंदर या बहुत मॉइस्ट जगह पे कहीं इनको हैंग कर दिया जाता है एक बैग में, कॉटन के बैग में भर के. एंड स्लोली व्हाट हैपेंस, द सॉफ्ट टिश्यू विल डीके एंड ओनली द लिग्निन विल बी देयर. सो इस तरीके से बनती है रोप. तो फिर उसे को सिर्फ स्क्लेरेनकाइमा को निकाल के कॉर्ड्स के फॉर्म में कन्वर्ट कर दिया जाता है. सो दिस हाउ द रोप इज़ फॉर्म. दिस प्रोसेस इज़ कॉल्ड रेटिंग. सो रेटिंग इज़ द प्रोसेस ऑफ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ रोप्स फ्रॉम द दीज प्लांट्स लाइक सन हैम, फ्लैक्स एंड जूट. सो नाउ नेक्स्ट थिंग इज़ लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द अदर टिश्यूज इन द प्लांट्स. So the other tissue is the epidermal tissue. So there are other tissues like there could be epidermal tissue, ground tissue and vascular bundles. So epidermal ka matlab hoga, epi means up or the upper layer, upper, and derma means the skin or the layer, upper layer. So this means this is the covering tissue of the plants. So whenever there is a covering tissue, it has to be always protective. So this may cover the roots, this may cover the leaves or the stem or even the fruits. So whatever is the covering, we call it as epidermis. So kaisi dikhti hai ye epidermal tissue? This is made up of a single layer of cells. Kabhi kabhi double layer bhi, more than one layer bhi hoti hai, jaise ki फाइकस की लीव्स के अंदर, जैसे कि रबर ट्री है उसकी लीव्स के अंदर इट इज़ डबल लेयर्ड, बट जनरली इट इज़ सिंगल लेयर्ड. सेल्स कैसे होंगे? देखो दिस टाइप ऑफ सेल्स, लाइक मैंने बैरल शेप्ड सेल्स बनाए हैं यहाँ. बैरल, यू नो बैरल इज़ द शेप दैट इज़ डेजिग्नेटेड बाय द दैट दैट काइंड ऑफ वुडन दिस बॉक्सेस जिसमें कि अल्कोहल फिल की जाती है. In fact, petroleum is also filled in or recorded or it is quantified in barrels. Now, this epidermis is covered by a thin layer of cuticle. Cuticle will prevent the evaporation of water or transpiration. This reduces the transpiration rate. Then there are stoma openings. These openings are having a guard cell. Now, the guard cells in the epidermis may have this chloroplast. Whereas other cell will not have. So other cells are colorless. They may have a big vacuole because they are differentiated cells. They have a nucleus, they are live cells. And these cells are protective. Now can you give me a notebook? Okay. So let me tell you what is this, where is this epidermal tissue present. Now suppose this notebook is the leaf. तो सपोज इस लीफ में आप, मैंने इस नोटबुक में देखो एक कवर है ऊपर की तरफ और एक है नीचे की तरफ. सो द अपर कवर इज़ व्हाट वी से इज़ द अपर एपिडर्मिस एंड द लोअर इज़ कॉल्ड द लोअर एपिडर्मिस. एंड जो इन बिटवीन दिख रहा है आपको, दिस इज़ द मीजोफिल. मीजो मीन्स इन बिटवीन, फिल इज़ लीफ. सो दैट इज़ द मिडिल पार्ट ऑफ द लीफ. सो बेसिकली किसी भी लीफ के अंदर एक अपर एपिडर्मिस होता है, एक लोअर एपिडर्मिस होता है और जो बाकी का टिश्यू दैट इज़ कॉल्ड द मीजोफिल. तो जो मीजोफिल है उसी में सिर्फ क्लोरोप्लास्ट होगा. एंड जनरली इन द एपिडर्मल अपर एंड लोअर एपिडर्मिस देर इज़ नो स्टोमेटा, सॉरी देर इज़ नो क्लोरोप्लास्ट. एंड फोटोसिंथेसिस भी कहाँ होगा? सिर्फ मीजोफिल के अंदर. तो अपर एपिडर्मिस में स्टोमेटा भी होंगे और लोअर एपिडर्मिस में भी स्टोमेटा होंगे. But then this will depend on कि what type of leaf it is. Suppose there is a dicot leaf. तो अगर dicot leaf है तो more stomata will be there on the lower side because that is not directly exposed to the sun. But अगर ये है monocot की leaf तो इसमें stomata दोनों equal number में होंगे, ऊपर भी और नीचे भी. Because this is equally exposed on both the sides. You have seen the orientation of the leaf. Monocot जैसे grasses की, maize की leaf कैसे होती है? दैट इज़ एक्सपोज लाइक दिस. और डायकॉट की लीव जो होती है दैट इज़ ऑलमोस्ट पैरेलल टू द सर्फेस ऑफ अर्थ. सो इट इज़ द अपर एपिडर्मिस मोर एक्सपोज टू सन. सो वहाँ पे क्या होगा? देर बी लेसर नंबर ऑफ स्टोमेटा. नाउ लुक एट दिस स्टोमेटा, स्टोमा सिंगल इज कॉल्ड स्टोमा एंड मेनी आर कॉल्ड स्टोमेटा, प्लूरल इज स्टोमेटा. नाउ हाउ दिस स्टोमेटा दे ओपन एंड क्लोज डाउन, लाइक सपोज डे टाइम में यू हैव सीन कि स्टोमेटा दे ओपन अप. दीज आर बेसिकली टू
हेल्प इन द ट्रांसपरेशन प्रोसेस एज वेल एज एक्सचेंज ऑफ गैसेज. तो दिन में स्टोमेटा ओपन होगा बिकॉज दिन में CO2 को अंदर आना होता है और ऑक्सीजन को रिलीज करना होता है एटमोसफेयर में. तो बिकॉज ऑक्सीजन CO2 इज नीडेड फॉर फोटोसिंथेसिस, यू नो CO2 प्लस वाटर दैट विल बी गिविंग आउट द ग्लूकोज एंड ऑक्सीजन. तो ऑक्सीजन इज फॉर्म्ड एज अ बाय प्रोडक्ट विच विल बी मूविंग आउट ऑफ द स्टोमेटा इन द डे टाइम. नाउ ये स्टोमेटा बंद और खुलता कैसे है, सपोज डे टाइम में इट इज़ ओपनिंग अप. सो वट एक्चुअली हैपन्स इन द स्टोमेटा सो दैट इट ओपन्स अप इन द डे टाइम. सो देर इज अ थ्योरी कॉल्ड पोटाशियम आयन एक्सचेंज थ्योरी गिवन बाय लेविट इन 1974 एंड ही डिस्क्राइब्ड हाउ द स्टोमेटा विल बी ओपनिंग एंड क्लोजिंग इन द डे टाइम एंड इन द नाइट टाइम दे आर क्लोजिंग डाउन. नाउ लेट इज फर्स्ट स्टार्ट विद द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ स्टोमेटा देन विल गो इन डिटेल्स ऑफ द थ्योरी. So let's see how the stomata they look like. So in dicot plants, the stomata are bean shaped, but in the monocot they'll be dumbbell shaped. So let us draw both the type. So this is the bean shaped stomatal guard cells. These are the guard cells. They have nucleus and they have this thick inner lining. Inner cell wall is thicker. And the opening is called the stomata. So there are these accessory subsidiary cells. This green color indicates the presence of chloroplast. Chloroplast is only present in the guard cells. These are the nuclei in the subsidiary cells. So let's label. Subsidiary cells and the guard cells, together they constitute the stomatal apparatus. So let's label. These are the guard cells. This is the stomata, the opening. Stoma is singular. The green thing is the chloroplast. Nucleus. So the whole thing, the subsidiary cells as well as the opening ke charon taraf guard cells or subsidiary cells together constitute the stomatal apparatus. Now let's see them in what type of stomata are there in the monocots. So monocots have these dumbbell shaped guard cells. They are surrounded by the subsidiary cells. Subsidiary cells ka bhi bahut important role hoga during the opening and closing. Again, there is some thick wall in the center and a thinner wall at the ends. These guard cells again have chloroplast and nuclei. Opening and closing dono mein same hogi, that the daytime they'll be open and in the night time they'll be closed. So in dicots, there'll be stomata present more on the lower epidermis, more on the lower side of the leaf. But in monocots, they're present on the equal number because the leaf is exposed equally on both the sides. So when I say that the stomata open, this opening, the opening is there in between. But suppose if they are closing down, so they will be appearing something like this. The opening will be gone. It's only the guard cells that will be there, that you can see. And this happens in the night generally.
In the night time, when the guard cells they close down, they appear like this, and this is because they are the guard cells will become flaccid. Flaccid means they'll be lacking water. Water will be flaccid, and they look like this. So the opening is closed. But daytime may, because you know there are chloroplasts in the guard cells, they'll be synthesizing a lot of starch. The starch is converted into glucose, and there'll be exchange of potassium ion from the surrounding, and that is what we call it as a potassium ion exchange theory. And because there'll be more water filled into the guard cells, they bulge off, and when they bulge off, so this opening is left, and because of that, that we say that the guard cells have, the stomata is open, but in the night they close down because there'll be no starch synthesis. So let's now talk about potassium ion exchange theory. This was given by Levitt in 1974. Now these potassium ions, they are exchanged with hydrogen ions from the subsidiary cells. And this happens in the daytime. This makes the guard cells turgid because of endoosmosis. But opposite happens in the night time. The guard cells, they are flaccid in the night. Flaccid means they'll be lacking water. There will be exosmosis and they lack water. And because of that, the stomata will be closing down. The opening will be gone.